Hello, everybody. Welcome back to another midweek update, our sermon update about what we're going to be talking about this coming Sunday. Excuse me. We are moving right along through the Gospel of Mark. We're going to be in chapter 3 this week. So read chapter 3, pay attention to the things that happen in chapter 3. Pay attention to what Jesus says and what he does. As I've been reminding you each week, both in the sermon and in this video, I believe I have at least, to pay attention to what Jesus says, maybe how he says it, right? Think about the tone of voice that you think Jesus has as he makes these different statements and these proclamations and does these healings and teachings and all these sorts of things. This week, we're going to be focused on the choosing of the 12 in chapter 3. This momentous event, right, that is this this reconstituting of Israel, right? Jesus is making a very bold statement here by naming 12 disciples, that these are now the new heads of Israel, right? The sons of Israel. And what do we do with that as Christians? How do we take that and use that? What does that mean to us? We're also going to be looking at how the religious leaders were throwing the accusation at Jesus that he was clearly doing everything that he was doing by the power of Satan. What does that mean, right? How could Jesus be doing that? What is his response to what they have to say? I think you're going to enjoy that. And then the final thing that we're going to talk about from chapter 3 is how the chapter ends. And it's Jesus talking about his family. Who is his true family? Now, this is going to actually be connected with his choosing of the 12 disciples. And we're going to make that connection. But who is Jesus's family? That's a big question. We've seen him do ministry in the region in which he grew up. What does it mean that Jesus has a family? And who is this family? Who could they be? And what importance do they have to him? And what does Jesus think about them as he continues in his ministry in Mark? So a lot to talk about there, right? There are several pieces that we're going to dive into. I'm not quite sure yet which one of those we're going to land the most on, right? Because they're all really good. There's a lot to talk about. But I do want to try to touch on all three of those things. So that starts in verse 13 and goes to the end of the chapter. But read all of chapter 3. Because, of course, it's good. It's good to read. And even though we may not be covering all of it, it's still beneficial for you to read God's word. So I want you to do that. I want you to be ready to come and talk Sunday about what we're going to be looking at. And I'm looking forward to diving into Mark chapter 3 with you, okay? So Mark chapter 3, come Sunday. I hope to see all of you there.